Hello, my name is Greg Bailey. I'm with Society Insurance's risk control team. Our goal is to help prevent accidental losses from happening in your business and provide you with resources to help you prevent them. Today's subject covers the automatic extinguishing system, or AES, the portable Class K fire extinguisher, and what to do in the event of a fire. First, a little history. When restaurants made the change from cooking from lard to vegetable oil, the old dry chemical systems failed to cool the fire below the auto ignition temperature. This change led to the UL300 wet chemical system that we see today. The wet chemical extinguishing agent is used in the AES system and also in the Class K portable fire extinguisher. The system and the portable K fire extinguisher are designed to work together. The AES system is a primary fire suppression system in the kitchen in the event of a fire. Maintaining the system is vital to ensure it's available in the event of a fire. A qualified service contractor must service the AES every 6 months. The AES nozzles must be directed over the cooking equipment and the covers in place to prevent the buildup of grease. A manual pull handle should be in the path of travel and easily accessible. The manual pull handle acts as a secondary option in case the AES does not automatically activate. Finally, the fusible links must be replaced following the manufacturer's guidelines. To determine if your system's compliant, look for the UL300 stamp located on the tank or on the cabinet. Additionally, the AES nozzles are designed to cover the top cooking surface of the cooking equipment, so the internal fryer cabinets are out of the coverage area and the nozzles may lead to a fire not being extinguished. The secondary option to suppress a commercial kitchen fire is a Class K wet chemical extinguisher. The Class K fire extinguisher uses the same wet chemical agent as the AES system. It is designed to be more portable in the event a fire occurs outside the AES coverage. The extinguisher should be mounted within 30 feet of all cooking equipment. It should be visible and readily accessible. The gauge should be in the green range, showing adequate pressure. The safety pin should be in place, and annual maintenance should be performed by a qualified service provider, and the extinguisher should have a tag displaying the date of servicing. In the event of a fire, Society Insurance recommends the immediate evacuation of all employees and customers. Employees and customers should meet at the closest rally point, and a headcount should be determined. From a safe location, immediately notify 911 to activate the emergency response. If the conditions are favorable to extinguish the fire, the AES system should be activated automatically. In the event the automatic activation does not happen, the manual pull handle should be activated by pulling the handle. With the activation of the AES or the manual pull station, the fuel source will be eliminated. The Class K extinguisher should then be used in the event of a fire outside of the AES coverage area. The Class K extinguisher is used utilizing the PASS system. PASS stands for pulling the pin, aiming the nozzle, squeezing the handle, and sweeping the nozzle back and forth at the base of the fire. This concludes our discussion of kitchen fires and the fire suppression system. For more videos, give us a like and subscribe.